I love those J-I-N-G-L-E bells. Oh, those holiday J-I-N-G-L-E bells. Oh, those happy J-I-N-G-L-E B-E-L-L-S. I love those J-I-N-G-L-E bells. Oh.
Morning, good morning. How's everybody doing today? Today is the 16th of December, 2019. I've been up throughout the night, but I've been up since about 5 o'clock this morning, 4:50 around there, because my baby woke up early. See, my baby woke up early. Well, he doesn't like to be recorded, but he woke up early, so I just came down here to, might as well get the kids ready for school.
Meow, meow,
kitty cat,
meow.
Well, anyways, I just want to say good morning, and I hope everybody had a wonderful rest. I only got about maybe 4 hours sleep. That's my usual, breaking down in like pieces. My eyes kind of hurt me today, so I just want to say that I'm grateful for another day the Lord gave me life. All my children, my husband too, are home. Even though I have a bunch of nightmares at night and I wake up with, I think I have panic attacks at night because my body don't rest or something. But I have nightmares and everything. So I just want to say good morning, guys. And this is the last week of school for my kids, and they're going to be on vacation. I have to take my Jason's teacher. I'm going to go get some honey, some of those Graham cookies that she needs, and maybe some jelly beans and some chocolate chips or something like that. But either way, because they're gonna make something with gingerbread and stuff like that. So I'm excited for this is the last week, thank God, so we could just not be rushing in the morning, just get up and do things slow. But anyways, I'm gonna get my baby because he's nagging, and I'm gonna have my cup of coffee. See, I got that coffee, that's not a cute tea. And I saved half of it for this morning, so I'll see you guys in a bit. I just want to keep you posted on what I'm doing. Corn tortillas, onions, tomatoes, and pieces of ham that I'm sauteing. Kind of like chilaquiles, but with eggs. So he could put some salsa on top. It's just corn tortillas that I had left over, and corn tortillas, as a matter of fact, I'll put it all in there. Cheese, 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 cheese. Corn tortillas, tomatoes, onions, and pieces of ham. That's all. That's what I made for breakfast, and then I made some beans. That's gonna be it, guys. I already took my kids to school, my baby's napping, so we're gonna eat breakfast. Okay, talk to you later. Thank you. Okay, the floor got cleaned. I wiped my little table there. Now I'm just gonna fold that laundry. But I already cleaned behind the couches and everything. So I moved the couches and everything. Now I even cleaned the table up there. There's our Liam's things. I need to donate those or something. These are the pillows to that couch over there, but I'm starting up the clothes, so don't get scared. Now I'm gonna fold these clothes. Now I got this little cast iron Dutch oven. I got it from Amazon yesterday.
and I want to use it. I think I'm going to make for lunch, and it's just me, my two daughters, and my baby today. I think I'm going to make a little bit about albondigas, only because I have these meatballs that I've had in the freezer that I need to use. So I'm going to see what kind of veggies I have there in the fridge so I can make them. See what I have. Hopefully I have celery, an onion, tomatoes. That's the most important stuff. Then I'll put some cabbage, maybe some other vegetables that I find in the freezer. It's going to be very fast because these are already cooked. They're the ones I have in a Sam's Club, the Italian meatballs. So I'm going to put them in there with some veggies so I can have like albondigas. Because I need to eat healthier, so that's what I'm going to have today. All right, guys, here's my albondigas. See the meatballs? Meatballs. And I overstuffed my little pot, but some of this is going to cook down a little bit. I got squash, I have cabbage, all these greens that I have to eat, broccoli, cauliflower, you name it. It's already cooked. I'm just going to let it simmer for maybe 5 minutes and that's it. Then over here I have some green chili. You see I use the big chili, the ones they roast outside the store. Hold on, let me lower this down. Get a little cup and get some of the juice out. Well, anyways, it's over spilling, but I'll take care of that. Just a little bit of juice out. Yeah. Anyways, you know the big chili that they roast out there, guys, in, at Food City and whatever store? The Mexican stores. Well, I bought to make chili rellenos about a week ago now, about 4 or 5 days ago. Four days. And they're there, and then they get bad if you don't use them. So I chopped them in little pieces. I threw it in here. But I also put about 10 chili serranos and 3 tomatoes in here because I want to make some burritos. Just some burritos so the kids could have them. Since they love green chili more than red. Here they are. I'm just going to make them like this. See? Green chilies. But I also seasoned the meat with garlic. Onion powder, cumin, bouillon cube, and salt. A little bit of salt. And I put some chiles in here and stuff and some of those stuff. Just so I can use them up. Let me taste it. OMG. Wow, it's delicious. I'm going to start making burritos in a little bit while that's simmering. I'm going to make those burritos right now. And like I was saying before, my phone turns off. I'm waiting for my albondigas to simmer. Now I'm going to start making the burritos. And I'm also going to... I have another little bag of those big old chiles. So I am going to make the chile rellenos. Just to let you know. And maybe I could make some rice on the side. People could have that. They could have the albondigas soup. Or they can have a burrito. Whatever. That's good enough for today. Right, guys? Let me get to it.
All right, guys. The chili's done. My albondigas are done. I'm going to turn it off. And now I got the chilies here. But I'm going to stuff with cheese and lift the white eggs. And then I'm going to start making them. Okay, guys. Now I'm starting the chili relleno process. I got the chilies here. Only because I want to use those chilies and I don't want them to go bad. So taking the little white, the white from the eggs out. And here. I find it easy just to put it on my clean hands. Let it drip. Put the yolk in there. I already got my cheese over here too. Like I said, I only have till 2 o'clock to do this. So I want to do these chile rellenos. I'll probably make some rice. And I got my albondigas done. I also have the green chili. I'm going to start making a bunch of burritos right now. Because they sure help. The kids like green chili a lot. But this time I put in my green chili burritos. I put some of these burritos and chile. So they're even gonna taste a lot better. But that's it, guys. Let me continue doing this and then I'll be back to show you. Woo! Alrighty, guys. I am starting to make my green chili burritos because my children love it and I have all these tortillas. I had this meat the other day there, and these are like perfect burritos. I already have burritos right there that I'm making. My other daughter's recording me because the other one puts the camera right in my face and I'm all like this. So I told my daughter, don't put the camera so close to my face. They can actually see all my pores and everything. I told her. She even focuses in my ear and stuff like that. My other daughter. So yeah, I'm having my other daughter Cassandra record me because, yeah, because I'm, when she records me, my other daughter, Stephanie, she records me really close and I have to be like, you guys see like every imperfection. But I told my daughter, don't put it too close to my face. So yeah, I'm making burritos, guys, because my children love green chili burritos and I have this meat there. So my burritos have a lot of meat. And I have this meat there and I said, I'm going to make them burritos. Easy for me to do and... easy for me to do and they are delicious. Because I put some of these really big chiles in there, you know, the ones that you roast. So it's going to be really, really delicious. Also, my albondigas are there and I can't wait to eat them. I have to eat a lot of greens, so yeah, guys, that's it. And then I'm gonna clean. That's all. I already did laundry. I folded it. I need to go put it away, but I need to do it slow. My boys are at school and they're the ones that keep me busy. Oh yeah, I want to clean all this counter thing here. I want to leave it blank, like if nothing, I don't have no dishes and stuff like that. I want to leave it like that, but I only have till 2 o'clock to cook every day, and it's already 1:32. So I'm just going to make the burritos here. I didn't even get to have lunch because I'm busy, but yeah. But my kids are going to have burritos. They're going to have albondigas. They're going to have... they're gonna have burritos, they're gonna have albondigas. Oh, I also made the chili rellenos. I took a picture and I showed it to you guys. I have this little bit of cheese left over. It's so good. Mm-hmm. So, that's where I'm at. Making green chili burritos. Yeah. I'll probably make them, I wanted to make horchata, but time flies when you're having fun, right, guys? In the kitchen. So, that's where I'm at, guys. And I'll keep you posted on what I'm doing. Today is... what is today, guys? The 16th? All right. We're on December 16th. And this is the last week of school for my boys and my Stephanie. I have 3 boys that go to school and 1 girl. Yeah, so can't wait to have my albondigas tonight. See what I mean? I was gonna put the chili on the foil, okay, guys? That's what happens when you don't sleep at night. Like one time I made my husband a sandwich and I forgot to put the bologna, the lunch meat. And I go, did you like the sandwich, darling? Yeah, I loved it. I mean, I love the bread and the lettuce and tomato and all that stuff, but I go, what? Oh, that's just one of those sleepless nights. But I caught myself. So, that's where I'm at. Burritos, burritos, burritos! Who wants to buy burritos? I've always wanted to have my burrito stand, guys. Does anybody want to have a burrito stand and needs to cook? I'll be the cook, and you guys can, you guys pay for the restaurant, and I'll be the cook. All right, guys, let me finish this, and I'll get back with you in a little bit. Adios, bon voyage, hasta la vista. Well, this is my burritos, guys. I made all these. And I made all these. And I'm eating this little bit that was left over. It wasn't enough to make like a full burrito, but I'm eating it. All right, guys, it's 1:46. I was done before 2.
and I'm headed to pick up my boys at school, and then I'm gonna drop them off, and then I'm gonna head to pick up my other children at the high school. I'll talk to you there.
Okay, I'm done making the burritos. I just came to sit down for a minute. I'm having these pecans. Not pecans, but what are they called? Cashews? Mm-hmm. Oops. Fell out. I'm trying to show you. But I'm going to go pick up my kids from school. I'm wet up here because I was washing the big old pants where I made the burritos and the water splashed on me and I got so angry. Well, anyways, I'm just waiting to sit here till 2 o'clock, and then I'm going to take off to pick up my boys. Oh, I wanted to tell you that I'm going to make a cheese ball. Mm-hmm. When I get home, I'm going to make a cheese ball because I bought 2 big boxes of crackers when I went to the store because they were on sale. I couldn't leave them, but they're the healthy kind. You know, if you can't have cholesterol, sugar, and all that stuff, they're the healthy kind, but they're really good. And I said, I have so much crackers there. I don't want them to just stay and go to waste and I have to throw them because whatever. So I'm going to make a cheese ball so the kids could dip in it. I took some of these bell peppers out. Yeah. Because I want to put them in there. Bacon bits. Maybe some green onion. And some cheddar cheese. That's if I have some. If I don't have none. I think I have a little bit of cheddar cheese. I don't know. But I'll show you guys. Hopefully I can make it today. If not, I'll just make it tomorrow. But yeah, that's it, guys. So my kitchen's semi-clean. My son's throwing the trash in the whole house. My baby's getting ready because he goes with me to pick up the kids. He likes to go for a ride. So I'm just going to go right now and put on my lipstick so I don't go nowhere without my lipstick. Mm-hmm. And, yep. My kids ask me every day. They text me, "Wait, Mom, what are you making for to eat?" And I tell them all the food. And they go, yum. I might make a little bit of rice when I get home. I will see. If not, oh well. I think I will because I put a little spoon of it in the side of my albondiga soup. Yeah, so I have to stop and go get some water too. I go by the water now because this big truck used to bring it to us all the time. But it kept bringing us more and more and more and more. Ended up with 30 gallons of water that... And when I told him to stop, cancel my card and everything, I told him to stop. They're still bringing it and charging me and bringing it and charging me month to month. And I just said, heck no, forget it. So now I just go buy the water at the water stations. So I'm not going to be getting paying for water that I'm not going to use. I mean, I told the kids. Well, anyways, guys, like I was saying, I'm going to end the video here today. We had our supper. I had albondigas. My husband and I had albondigas. And then we had not him, because he doesn't like those, but I had 2 chile rellenos with 2 corn tortillas. Like, I put a chile relleno in each tortilla, and I ate it with my albondigas. Mm-hmm. My albondigas, I put tapatio sauce and lime, and it was delicious. He put Parmesan cheese on his. My eyes are itching me right now. I'm at Walmart, actually, because I came to buy some paper cups and some little boxes of chocolate because the kids are going to make in their classroom little gingerbreads, and then they're going to make hot chocolate for the last day, I believe, of school. So I came to buy this so my son could take it to school. Then and that's all I came to buy. So my daughter's inside Walmart. I go, let's run and get it now. That way my son could take it tomorrow to his teacher. Yeah, so we're at Walmart. I'm at the parking lot. It's kind of dark. That's why I come over, park over here by the light. So, anyways, I just want to say good night. God bless you all. Have a wonderful night. And I'll pray for all my subscribers and everything so that they can have good night's sleep and restful nights. And wake up rejoicing in the Lord's name with their families, their jobs, their children, their schools, everything, okay? Because you guys are part of my family now, our family. So when I pray for my husband, I pray for you guys too. I'm sorry, I'm just watching now, make sure, you know, nobody's gonna come around my car and try to open my door or something. But yeah, so when we pray for all my subscribers and their families and everything. So yeah, thank you so much for your support as always. And that's it. one more weekend of Christmas weekend, just the last one. And I'm just thinking, I still have to do a lot of Christmas shopping, but I'll get it done some way, somehow. Okay, guys. Well, God bless you guys. Good night. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Okay? Have a wonderful sleep. Thank you. Bye-bye.
I love those